morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good to see you here. I'm a little shorter than our last speaker, I think. My brother was supposed to help. If you see the announcements, they're on the back. But he, rightly so, decided he would rather go to see to a graduation party for his grandson in Council Bluffs. So good for him. If there aren't any big announcements this morning, anybody have anything they want to announce? I would like to welcome Andrea Johnson to our keyboard this morning and her daughter, Vivian. I believe Vivian is 7?
Almost 7.
Okay, so we welcome you to our worship this morning. We're grateful to have you. May the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
God created all things visible and invisible, none other.
God provides food, stomach, and spirit, none other.
God is able to accomplish abundantly far more than all we can ask or imagine.
Let us worship the Trinity and none other.
Our opening hymn is number 263, Immortal, Invisible, God Only Wise. And all of our hymns will be in the Presbyterian hymnal. And you may stay seated this morning. And then we will join together in our prayer of confession. Siblings in Christ, if we say we have no sin, then we deceive ourselves. And the truth is not in us, but God, who is faithful and just, forgives our sin, cleanses us from all unrighteousness. Let us pray together our confession of sin. God of wonder, Lord of King David, and of the Son, the Messiah, David's greater son, we confess our sins and pray for your help so that we can truly repent and turn from evil. Deliver us from the temptation to hide from you, to lie to you, or to excuse ourselves because of the harm we have done to others. Forgive us for the curse we have brought upon the earth. Restore your creation to full health and feed the multitudes from the abundance of your merciful power. Grow in us a deeper desire to love Christ with the fullness of your love, and to glorify him, along with you and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. The river of God's mercy runs deeper and wider than our sin. God removed our sin as far as the heavens are above the earth. Beloved in risen Christ, we are forgiven. Amen. O Holy Spirit, creative power of God, join me, please. O Holy Spirit, creative power of God, strengthen us to the depths of our humanity. Help us to overcome temptations to abuse our neighbors. Fill us with the love of Christ. Feed us the bread of heaven, so that we will share with the world the saying that is true, I am is with us. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ, Son of God, Savior. Amen. Not enough room up here. Excuse me. Our scripture this morning comes from Philippians 4, 6 to 7. And I'd like you to think about something while you're listening to the scripture. What are your worries? What concerns can you make known to God, knowing that God is always with you? Has there been a difficult time in your life that, either now or at the time, you recognize the presence of God? So consider Philippians 4, 6 to 7. Do not worry about anything, and in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. So I have a confession to make. I did not write this sermon. I came across this sermon, which was actually written by Patrick D. Heary, who serves as a pastor at Westminster Presbyterian Church in Auburn, New York, and is a husband and a father. And this was in Horizons Magazine, which is the Presbyterian women's magazine. I'm not doing all of it, but parts of it speak so much to us personally, and maybe some of the thoughts, secret thoughts, or things you've said out loud that happened to us in our lives. So we are often spread too thin. Raise your hand if you've ever thought, I'm spread too thin. I have too many things to do. Too many people are depending on me. A lot of times it feels like no matter how hard we try, we're letting someone down. Take your pick. Not a good enough parent or grandparent. Not a good enough spouse or friend. Or not good enough at your job or at life. Not good enough citizen not a good enough Christian. We echo Bilbo Baggins in the Lord of the Rings series when he says, I feel thin, sort of stretched, like butter scraped over too much bread. All our culture's answer is to say, you've got this. You can do anything you put your mind to. Has anybody heard that before? Just try harder. Believe in yourself. You are enough. Sounds nice, if only it were true. What I'm about to say won't sell any t-shirts or timeshares, but here it is. You are not enough, and you never will be. You don't got this. You can't do everything just by trying harder. I know. At first, that statement may wound you in the same way it wounds me, but isn't it fundamentally true? We are finite beings. We have limits. There are only so many hours in a day. Everything is a choice. If I choose to be over here, I can't be over there. If I choose to help this person, well, I'm choosing not to help that person. Even more fundamentally, I am a broken person. Remember my sister saying broken vessel last Sunday. I am a broken person. Beautiful, yes. Loved, yes. But broken, imperfect, sinful. And that brokenness, it shows up in my relationships, my job, my discipleship. I get impatient, angry, selfish. I stop listening. I interrupt. I walk away. Or maybe I just prioritize the wrong things. I'm so busy looking right that I don't see left. Right? Left. Or to use another but slightly less frustrating proverb, I can't see the forest for the trees. We are imperfect, yet perfectly loved. Isn't there relief in accepting that we don't have to be perfect? Yeah, I'm falling apart, and so is everyone else. We don't have to pretend anymore. We don't have to keep pushing, trying to keep it together. Life is difficult right now, and we could really use some solidarity and or help. I'm not saying that we should abandon ambition or working hard or trying to improve ourselves. I'm asking, what peace might we find when we accept that we have limits? Since all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, writes the Apostle Paul in Romans 3:23, not to depress us, but to assure us that we're all imperfect. Of course, that would be depressing if that's where the gospel ended. So, yeah, we are measured, as the world tells us, by what we accomplish, by what we do, then we'll never be enough. The gospel, however, suggests living by a different standard. In 2 Timothy, the author writes, "Join with me in relying on the power of God, who saved us and called us with a holy calling, not according to our works, but according to God's own purpose and grace." Paul suggests that if God is love, as 1 John states, then God sees us, judges us, not through the lens of our successes and failures, but through the lens of God's own divine love. It is no different for human parents and their children. How many of you have a child, young adult, or even adult in your life, who wears on the patience and goodwill of their family? Or perhaps you were or are that person. And yet, through tantrums, tears shed, harsh words exchanged, a deep bond and affection remain. And we're all imperfect. You'd better believe that God can still love us, no matter what we've done. Sometimes that's hard to imagine because we know that we can't do that so often. When you look in that mirror, you see yourself. You see the person who's not quite enough. What if God sees Christ standing there with you, his arms wrapped around you, his strength, his love pouring over you? What if God sees the wondrous child God always knew you to be, the wondrous soul you always were? You just maybe didn't know it because you thought you stood there alone. We are strengthened by Christ. Christ has carried you more times than you know. How many of you remember the poem about the footprints? And there was a time where I didn't see those footprints anymore. Why, God? And he says, because I was carrying you. Christ has carried you more times than you know. God says to Paul, "My grace is sufficient for power, is made perfect in weakness." It's those moments when we're on our knees and we don't know how we're going to make it another day that God raises us taller than we've ever been before. God, Paul says, "I will boast all the more gladly of my weaknesses so that the power of Christ may dwell in me." Therefore, I am content with weaknesses, insults, hardships, persecutions, and calamities for the sake of Christ. For whenever I am weak, then I am strong. Like that wonderful song about Jesus. Our weakness creates room for God's Spirit to dwell in us, to work through us. Or as John the Baptist once said, he must increase, but I must decrease. John 3:30. I felt this recently. I had two really good days of putting God first, but then on the third day, I woke tired. I felt no will to meet the day and its demands. How many of you have done that? You felt really energetic. You got enough done for a couple days, and then it's like, I still do this. But then on the third day, I woke tired. I felt no will to meet the day and its demands. As I drove to church and I thought about this passage from 2 Corinthians, I began to repeat, when I am weak, you are strong. When I am weak, you are strong. And you know what? I had an amazing day. God brought me to meet a mother of five children who survived domestic violence. I sat and talked about life and God with a member of this church. I cared for a person who was grieving. I began to write this sermon, and, oh yeah, I still struggled. But it was precisely when I felt that I had nothing left to give that God took over. God filled the space I left. Covered by Christ, we become enough. Together, we become enough. In God's love and grace, we become enough. Because it's not what you do, it's who loves you that counts. Martin Luther suggested that instead of asking ourselves, what have I done? Where have I sinned? What have I deserved? We should ask, what has Christ done? What has he deserved? Yours is to do what's good. Offer what love you can with what time and limits you have, knowing it will be imperfect, and that's okay, because you are not alone and because God loves you. Before you woke up this morning, before you did anything, you, with God's love, were enough. And at the end of this day, and all that you have done or left undone, all that you have said or left unsaid, all your achievements and all your mistakes. Even if you did nothing at all or made a total mess, you will be enough. Because God loves you. Because God is with you. Because the one who is enough, Christ Jesus, covers you. Amen. Thank you. come to the prayers of the people. Is there anybody that wants to fill out a name that we can hold to our hearts in prayer? Okay. Let us go to God in prayer. O Lord, have mercy upon us. O Christ, have mercy upon us. O Spirit, have mercy upon us and grant us your peace. We pray for those who have no peace, for children, women, and men whose homes have been destroyed by war, whose minds have been damaged by what they have seen or felt or done, who are hungry or thirsty or ill because they are refugees or poor or underpaid or trapped in human trafficking. We pray for those whom we have called to be peacemakers, leaders of governments and businesses and non-governmental organizations, leaders of the church and scholars and scientists and educators, community organizers and citizens and everyone of sound mind and body who can bear the burdens of the weak. Give us strength and courage and faith to trust Jesus Christ and to be Christ-like for the good of the creation you are redeeming, and to the glory of the one who redeems all, who with you and the Holy Spirit we worship now and forever. Let us pray the prayer that the Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Our closing hymn is number 429, Lord, You Give the Great Commission.
Thank you.
Stand as you are able for the empowerment and blessing. Share the bread of life with all whom you meet. Let the spirit of life strengthen your whole being and be open to the transforming of your soul by the fullness of God. May God feed you with open arms, protect you with mighty arms, heal you with gentle fingers. The scent of bread, fish, and grace linger in the clothing of your heart and renew your faith with strong sea winds blow. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
Amen.